Hello, my name's Al Morocco. This is my wife, Dot. And welcome to my sugar shack. My name's Al Morocco, and this is my awesome wife, Dot Morocco, and this is my sugar shack. Years ago, when I started making syrup, I used to do it outside in the weather, and for about 5 to 6 years, the wind, the snow, the rain, it was just very hard to deal with. Of course, I had some really good days when it was just beautiful, but I just felt like I needed something to have to cook it inside, somewhere I can cook inside. So we homeschooled all our children, and I just come up with this idea. Well, my wife said, why don't you build a sugar shack? So I thought, well, that's a great idea. So my goal in my mind, I thought, well, it's going to cost a lot of money to build a sugar shack. But I found my brother had some wood that from old skids and telephone poles, and just I found a bunch of stuff that I could build this with. So I decided, I'll talk to my son. We decided to go ahead and start building. So I had some rocks, had some lumber, skids, and we ended up doing this as like a homeschool project. So this is our accomplishment here. We worked on this for about 3 or 4 months, but every year I'd add something else. I'd add drywall, I'd add different lighting or whatever, anything that I could come up that didn't cost anything. So most of the stuff that you see here is free, someone has given me, or someone was thrown away that I took and used it to build the sugar shack. So I worked at Sullivan Hospital, which is called Missouri Baptist Hospital now, in Sullivan. And there was a certain person that worked in ER. And so she brought me a jar. And I, you know, had some of that. And I said, where'd you get this? And she said, my uncle makes it. And so I said, I'd like to go see how he did it, you know, what he does and how he does it. And so she made arrangements. I went down there. And when I pulled up, it was just like an old garage, little, like the old farm garage, single car garage. And he had a pan. They were sitting in there just so comfortable and enjoying themselves. And I thought, man, this really looks cool. And there were jugs on the trees. And so I went there and kind of asked him some questions. And I told my wife, I said, I'm going to do this. And it's not going to cost, I'm going to try not to spend any money doing it. My focus is not to spend money, because I'm kind of a jack of all trades, master of none kind of person. So, and that's how I got started. When syrup season in my mind comes around, it'll be January 1st is my goal. It depends on the weather. If it's cold, frozen, you know, really cold, I don't do anything. I just wait until we have a nice 35 degree day. I gather all my buckets, and I already have them made up. I clean them every year. And so I gather my buckets, I get my tractor in the wagon, throw my buckets in there, my drill, my taps, and I just go tapping my trees. And it takes me about, I don't know, hour and a half to get all my trees tapped, which you don't go by how many trees do you got tapped. You go by how many taps do you have, kind of. So I normally tap about 150 taps. Some trees take one tap, some trees take two or three, which I like the three tappers, because that's just less work, you know, when you go gathering. And I gather my sap with my tractor. I walk the woods. I gather it with a 5 gallon bucket and dump it in my barrels. bring it back to the sugar shack, and then I transport it by hand in these barrels here that I have, and I cover them up. And I pretty well, I normally save the first batch, you know, like I might get a barrel. If I get two barrels, then what I normally do is put it in the pan first. Then I start gathering more the next day, and I try to get about a pan full and two barrels full, and then I start cooking. But if it's going to be more than 3 days, I cook, because I don't let it set any longer than 3 days. You can let it set longer, but I don't. The fun about it to me is just sitting here and enjoying the cooking sap and bringing it down to syrup. I'll try to cook it down to about 216. I don't have no thermometer. I could tell by the bubbles. So I've done it long enough. Now before, I'd burn it. So I'd have to bring it in earlier. Like, you know, it would take days to cook it in my house. So now that I've done it so long, I can just tell. I can look at the bubbles and how it foams, and, you know, I keep it going kind of thing. And when it really starts foaming, you could throw a little sap in there and that'll drop it. That'll stop the foam. I don't use any defoamers. I don't use butter, oils, nothing. So everything that's in my jar is just syrup. What I do is I'll open this door and I'll throw in a piece of tin to cover the fire. And then I'll open my flue wide open and all that heat goes straight up the flue. Then I'll just, what I do is dip it, well, I pour it out with this spigot here, open that up, get most of it out, and then I'll lift that pan out and then dip it out. So, okay, I'm gonna just show you my bucket and my tap. This is just a plastic tea bucket. I don't use any kind of bleach bucket or container, you know, gallon jug. Anything with chemicals, I do not use that type of jug. But I use everything that, like, people would drink out of. I don't use milk because normally when I get a milk container, no one's washed it out properly, and so it stinks, and I just don't care for that. So water jugs and tea jugs, rinse them out. I'll drill the hole. And then this is my tap made out of water PVC. It's a half-inch tap. But when I drill the hole with that angle, it squeezes. When I tap that in there, it'll squeeze that to where when it goes in and I put a little weight on, it holds the tap in and there's plenty of room for the sap to go through. Now this little invention, I did not invent. I stole this from another syrup producer, which actually he was learning himself. I mean, the first year he tapped the trees, this was one of his little deals that he put on his taps. That is so important because years ago I used to cut a groove in there and then this would sit in the groove like that. And the wind would blow and it would just fall off. So when you use that wire tie, the wind blows, it does not come off. And once you get a little weight in there, it won't come off anyway. But that saves me from going around picking up jugs. Plus, if the jug falls off, all the sap is wasted because it's just going to sit there and drip on the ground. So that right there is a winner. So, and it don't cost, this is pennies and this is free. So if you want to tap some trees and it don't cost you anything, that's how you do it. Right there, that's about 5.5 inches. There you go. This here is January, okay? That's my January syrup. This is January. Of course, it's a little darker because it's in a quart. This is February, and this here is, that's late February. So, and if it really gets warm, it even gets darker than that. So that's what that is. And what I do here is we have open houses, families that come that have never tasted homemade maple syrup, don't know nothing about it. They know about other syrups, which is really corn syrup with flavoring. And so what I try to do is put in their mind an idea to where they can make this syrup. There's nothing to it. You just gather sap and boil it down to a certain temperature. There's no special chemistry, you know. Anybody can boil water. It's just like boiling water until the very end. Then you got to slow down. You know, I kind of teach them how temperatures. I go by temperatures. I don't go by no hydrometers or whatever they use. And I try to teach families how to do it for their tradition in their lives, to bring them together as a unit, because family is the most important part in our country, I feel.